Okay. Yeah. Beautiful. Go ahead, Oksana.
Hi, I'm Alice. I'm 23, and I hope I'm fluent in English enough to speak to you.
My name is Oksana. I'm 18 years old.
Hello, my name is Olga.
My name is
Zhedmireva
Galina Mikhailovna.
I am
50 years old. Good afternoon, my name is Lena. I am 28. My height is 1 meter 75 centimeters. My weight is 67 kilograms.
I'm looking for kind, sensitive men. I hope it will be an American, and age and size, it doesn't really matter.
The world has no happiness, but there is a freedom, peace, and long have I daydreamed the life of bliss, and long have planned a tired slave, the flight to the removed abode of labor and delight. It's time, my friend Pushkin.
In Russia we say, Хто не рискует, тот не пьет шампанское, which means who doesn't risk, doesn't drink champagne. We look at life like an adventure, an endless chain of crossroads demanding choices. We are all faced with one or more of these turning points in our lives. At some time we are pushed, dragged or enticed to leave the comfort of our ever dull, ordinary experience and take a chance. For me, it began at the age of 16, when I left the small country home of my parents to live in Kyiv, a move which unexpectedly brought me to America years later. When I was a little girl, I would dream of coming to America. I wanted to be rich and famous. Well, I live in Boston now, still working on a rich and famous part. And now I'm on my way to Las Vegas to begin a movie about choices, choices that change lives. But this is not my story, it's a story of motives and dreams of Russian women and American men. Living in Ukraine, I could only dream about going to Las Vegas, a dream roughly equivalent to traveling to the moon. Many life-changing choices later, and here I am, in Las Vegas, to meet Charlie Champagne. Charlie runs a casino and an internet dating agency. You could say he is one of those crossroads. That's me on Charlie's website, advertising to get interviews for my documentary. For many, the adventure begins here.
Hi, Tatyana. Welcome to Las Vegas. Nice to see you. Come on in. Come in. You're welcome.
I have a dream, but I never planned to do it. I always thought about America, that it's a beautiful country where people live rich and happy, have easy life, they don't do much.
Well, like any girl, I dreamed to come to America, and I thought it would be wonderful, it would be different, it would be all my dreams just coming from sudden.
I thought about going to America. I thought about America, that this country is where you can get anything you want. You can achieve any goal.
We all saw and see on the TV. All they do, Americans, dress up themselves and go into restaurant to relax. And they don't have problems in relationships because they have everything.
In Russia, when they show American movies, they showed, for instance, like regular American family has 2-3 new cars, okay? They have like 2-3 floors house. They don't work and they live several months or years and they like travel all over, you know, and they buy stuff. They showed not real life in America.
I didn't turn the heater on, but it's been hot enough, the water. When I started using a computer for my bar business, I started using the internet and I came across some agencies that were introducing Eastern European women to Western men. And after taking my first trip to Kiev, I got to know a few more ladies, and they all asked if I could be of any help to them by maybe designing a website and listing their profile and pictures on the internet for men to see and to be able to correspond with them.
Well, I came here from Las Vegas, from California, Los Angeles. I moved here mostly for work. I work for an airline, so I always wanted to travel. And one of the places I always wanted to go was Russia, because they were our mortal enemies for years, you know. A couple of my friends wanted to go also. We're looking on the internet, looking up things on Russia. And when you type in Russia, believe it or not, as you go down, you're finally going to hit girls, because there are so many agencies in Russia and America that have people meet. So that piqued our interest. As long as we're going, we might as well go and meet girls as long as we're there. You know, why not?
My name is Roger Babineau. I'm in my late 30s. I was born in Salem, Massachusetts. I had always been somewhat fascinated with not particularly Russia, but the off-Russian countries that basically became independent after Russia broke up, the Ukraine, Belarus. Just wonderful picture. Prior to, was it 82 or whatever, you couldn't go there and see. I ended up on the internet and did some research. Do searches on Russia and you would find, you know, find Russian women and all this stuff. If you look at what is predominantly, you know, considered to be Russian women, it's basically little old ladies with towels on their heads and they look like they're 200 years old. Doing the research and such, I found that that wasn't the case. That kind of intrigued me. Okay, this is interesting. I want to go see this. And, you know, it was something that, since I needed to take a vacation and I had all the time and I had a lot of money saved up, you know, let's just go and see what's over there.
My name is Gary. I was born in Pawtucket, Rhode Island. Went to school in a town nearby. I went to a college in upstate New York, where I got my bachelor's degree in television and radio. And I've been working at television stations ever since. And a couple of years ago, I met Natasha. Before Natasha, I never really emailed people that much.
I sent him my pictures, he loved me. He called me like twice a week.
Yeah, you kind of want to meet the person that you've been, you know, you want to have a face with the voice or something like that. I didn't think it was that big of a deal to go over there.
I was born in Latvia. My childhood was in Ukraine with my grandparents. She raised me as a nice country girl. I learned to do gardening, I learned how to do crafting, I learned how to do housekeeping, I mean everything possible you can imagine, even farming. After perestroika, I decided to live on my own and I moved to Kyiv city. I was working at a sewing factory, seamstress. It was very difficult to live in Kyiv, constantly not enough money. It's really hard to survive. It's really hard to survive. At the end of the month, you come to the point that, okay, I really don't have anything to eat. All I have is couple cents to buy myself a piece of bread for tomorrow. And it's actually happened to me. And then I was looking, I can't take it anymore. You have to do something to change it.
Anyway, I was born in St. Petersburg. I came here about 5 years ago on fiancé visa and got married to my husband, Thomas Mayer. I was born to a poor family. My mother wouldn't make enough money to support us, and I didn't have father. My father left our family when I was really young, and we had to survive on our own. I didn't have a good relationship with my mother, but when I was 16, I left house to live with my boyfriend, and that's when my life started to be much better.
My name is Natasha, and I came from Ukraine last year. I came here, I got married last September, so it's almost a year. My parents divorced, and when I didn't work, my mom supported me. My mom is 47 years old, she got laid off. If I wasn't rich, it means I was poor, but I wasn't poor, I had enough to eat.
More and more Russian women are finding out that there are men coming from other countries that they would find much more appealing than the Russian man.
I don't want to have a Russian man as my husband. They have this idea that they can cheat, women can't. In relationships, in family, there is no such thing like 50-50, you know. A man is the main. What I like about American men, they both work usually, and they share, like, I don't know, house duties, you know.
Well, they don't have romance in Ukraine. It was difficult to build relationship when you have no place to live and you don't have a stable job. So I guess I was not perfect candidate for life.
Basically, it's difficult to find a good man.
Do you believe in fate, or must we ride the wave of chance? Should we wait for happiness to find us, or pursue it relentlessly? Like the mail order brides of American pioneer days, many Ukrainian and Russian women are turning to the West. They are looking for a new life, a new destiny, away from the harsh reality that is their home.
If you're going to go there anyway and you would like to meet single people, an agency is the best way to go because you will meet quality people who are very serious about also meeting someone. So it would be a lot nicer and safer also.
this agency really gave me the opportunity to just, you know, mingle with people and talk to different people. And it was, you know, there were some very interesting people that I met.
I can tell you about two agencies I had experience with, and basically one of them is major St. Petersburg agency. And they use catalogs like any other agency, and basically people come and they leave their information and photos, and they have professional photographer. Photographs of me and Natasha was really great. They put us in catalog like everybody else. They had a lot of girls in catalog already, and basically they had men scheduled to come a few times a day, and they look through catalog and they choose, like I said, 5 to 10 girls per day, and it's about 3-day program. So for 3 days, they see from 15 to 30 girls, and they have date with every girl. They invite interpreter for the service, and they go to restaurant. So men have to eat 5 to 10 times per day while they're in Russia, and feed all the girls and interpreter and whoever is responsible for putting them together. So basically it's very expensive for them.
Yeah, some of the bigger agencies, the way they make money is by setting up tours. Come in, come on in. How you doing?
It's very simple, really. I mean, you contact the agency and tell them, you know, when you're going to be there on vacation, or if you want to take a vacation with them. If you want to go with them, everyone meets usually in New York, because they all go on the same flight. That way everyone can meet each other. And you just fly over, you stay in the same hotel.
Of course, they put the most attractive women in catalogs. I have big experience, actually. Because my older sister, she doesn't look like I do. I mean, she's tall, beautiful, and blonde. When she was 17, she worked as a model, and she worked for one Russian-American agency. She lived in Moscow. What they did, they put her pictures like on the first page in catalogs, and they gave the ad, and they said that she's available. So a lot of American men saw her, and they came to meet her, and she had dinner with them. It was part of her job, okay? She had dinner with them, and after she said, oh, I'm sorry, you're a nice person, but I don't really interest in. So when the men were there, agencies began like to find somebody for them.
Yeah, I've seen the websites, I've seen the catalogs. They're basically just pictures, and it just says a little something about them. You know, how old they are, what city they live in, kind of like a basic interest they have. But at least this way a man can see a picture and say, oh, well, she's pretty, you know, I'd like to meet her. She has maybe the same interests I do. You know, with the agency, they're single. Most, 99% of them are very serious.
Each man out of the 20 to 40 men that go on these tours with the agency will have an opportunity to meet anywhere from 600 to 1,000 women.
And basically they just rent a big hall, either in the hotel or maybe a big disco, somewhere that can take a lot of people. And basically they just call the ladies and tell them that, you know, there's a group of single men that would like to meet them and vice versa, and that's basically it.
And they make like party, they rent like some restaurant or something, and then invite for 8 to 10 men, like maybe about 50 or maybe 100 women. Okay, so I really have nothing good to say about this agency. It's very disappointed, really, and humiliating for women, for Russian women especially.
I happened to be in one of those parties that you've been talking about, and I didn't enjoy it at all. It was really strange. It was really actually nice restaurant, and very nicely set up and everything, but it was 5 really, not pretty guys from America, and they was older, and was really picky, and was 25 young, beautiful girls
But once everyone gets together, they just talk and, and dance and just get to know each other. And if you meet someone that you have a connection with, you just go out on a date. That's basically all the agencies are. They just get people together.
It feels like they came here and they could buy anybody and everybody would just be sold in a second and they could pick any girl. And
if I wanted to go there and just, you know, pick the most attractive woman and go that way, you know, I could have done that. You know, it was not a problem. You just go out on the street and you just, hey, you, and you could, you know, you could take off with one.
An older American man that's middle class or above could fairly much have the pick of the litter of how young and how pretty the woman he's looking for.
My opinion was, it's like, you know, horse selling. I mean, like they sell horses. Men just go around all, usually it's men older than 40, 45, 50 years. Usually they not attractive at all, but they're wealthy. And, you know, they just go around looking for women and not all of them, of course, I mean, but, and they just like pick up, you know, who's more beautiful. They even don't care about their character. They just see who's more sexual, who's more beautiful and more attractive. So this is the way.
We are all looking for a love. But if we don't find it, we compromise and settle for what we can get. Sometimes loneliness may push us to take a great risk. Imagine two people from different cultures meet and they must decide in a short time, probably only a week, if they want to spend their lives together.
Like destiny, he told me he fell in love.
I was really surprised when he said that he was interested in meeting me.
I started to get letters. It was a lot of different men of any kind, any type. And the Thomas actually was the first one who wrote to me and the first one who came to Russia to see me. He was really fast.
First time Moscow. 3 years ago, went to Moscow, Red Square, Kremlin, then we hooked up with the agency when we were there. But no, I didn't meet anyone.
Once, in the middle of the winter, went to Ukraine to see Natasha for about 2 weeks.
I was waiting for him. I met him in Kyiv in airport and we spent 2 days in Kyiv. Oh my God, poor Gary. He looks so strange. You know, it was January cold and he went in sneakers without hat in very easy leather jacket.
One of the days that I was there, I met Elena. We just clicked. I talked to her for a while through the interpreter and I found her very interesting. This is a person that I like, you know, let's go to dinner.
I thought I had nothing to do and it was very expensive. I never been to a restaurant before. I decided to go.
From day one and from first minute, he wanted to get married. He wasn't showing that he really attracted to me as man to woman, but he was really interested in getting married to me.
So, I know I've never understood people that want to work. I never have. The world is huge. You know, I want to travel, see the world, do what I want to do, take classes.
You went to Russia. Have you met somebody already? Like, did you meet somebody at least you like?
Oh, yeah. In St. Petersburg, I did. I called. She spoke really good English. We had a good time, though.
Okay.
We became friends.
It didn't work some.
No, she was a little too young.
We spent 2 weeks together. All my friends wanted to see him very badly, and because he's American, wow, American came.
So we fought sometimes during the two weeks that I was there.
Yeah, actually, yes, especially when we were in Kharkov and we were staying at house, it was cold and there wasn't light like for hours or something.
Yeah, definitely.
It was a scary movie,
yeah? Yeah, that's right.
We went back to St. Petersburg again.
And did you meet somebody that time?
Yeah, actually I did. Yeah, she was very nice. We had a great time together. But it just, I just didn't feel it was going to work out. We kind of wanted different things out of life.
I didn't speak any English. It was difficult because he had his little book and he was looking for the words to show me what he mean, and it was funny.
And we learned each other's language by talking to each other.
We knew each other for 5-6 days, and he had to come back to America.
We really had very good time. My mom liked him. I liked him too.
Not only did I get to meet Natasha, but it's a nice vacation. I mean, it's something out of the ordinary. It's something that you probably only get to do once in your life.
It was the day before I left, I asked her. And she said yes, and I left her some money to take English lessons.
He said that he would like to see me in America, and I didn't expect it. I didn't believe that I ever will come.
So do you think for all the 6 trips, did you meet somebody, did you have somebody now you would seriously consider?
No. Not right now. I mean, I'm very particular. Not that I'm so great or anything. It's just that, you know, you're talking about the rest of your life.
I mean, it took a while, and it probably even took longer after, you know, I got back here to decide that she was definitely going to come over. And,
yeah,
you know, we just wanted to be together. It wasn't necessarily that we wanted to get married right away. It's just if you want to be together and we wanted to be here, then you don't really have much other choice. So, you know, you have, what is it, 3 months to decide, and that's it.
Before he came back, he proposed me. He asked me to come here. I liked him, of course, but I can't really say that it was like love.
Access to the embassy, this paperwork, and I got this visa. Thank God. And then only I called to my brother and tell my sister-in-law. She picked up the phone and she said, "Where are you?" I said, "I'm in worse. Get the chair because you're gonna fall down." And she said, "What? Where are you going?" I said, "I'm going to America and I don't know when I'm gonna see you again."
A couple days from after my graduation, I had interview in embassy, and the next day after interview, I flied from Warsaw to New York City. After I flied from New York to Boston, where Gary met me actually, and it was nice. I was very impressed, especially, you know, it was night and all these lights, all these highways. Oh my God, it was amazing. I was so happy, you know.
When I came here, my first husband, Thomas, told me that we're going to make a really nice family. We're going to raise children together. We're going to clean the house. We're going to have co-parent-partner relationship. And when I asked him what about love, he told me that he did not promise me to love me, but he did promise to support me, and if I'm looking for love, I better go to France.
When I came first time over Roger's apartment, and I found that he was promising too much, and he was describing me all this living totally different the way I saw it myself. He didn't have much in savings, and I decided to take this chance and do start building my life from very beginning.
I think the first couple of days she was happy, but she was also scared. She took a risk. She got on a plane and flew X amount of miles to be here where she knew absolutely no one and, you know, cross her fingers that I was going to show up at the airport and pick her up.
And I had chance to look around. I had 3 months to decide whether I want to get married or I could have come back in Ukraine back and live as the same as it was before.
I was impressed when I saw his car. I said, oh my god, the most amazing car I ever seen in my life. Sporty and red. I just fell in love. You remember it? I keep telling you that I love.
When I first came to America, I was really shocked, and my life here, especially the first 2 years, was really uncomfortable and difficult for me. Thomas lived in a small town. It's basically a suburban area of Boston, Dedham. For him, it's nearby. For me, it was really in the middle of nowhere, and I felt really uncomfortable. Even so, I got pregnant right away, and I wasn't happy about it. But he's a Catholic, so he's against abortions, and he wanted to get married even more after he discovered that I'm pregnant.
We wanted to make sure that the wedding that we set up was the right wedding for us. We got a little chapel in Leominster, we got a little club in Leominster, and we just, you know, we did it very nicely. But trying to get a wedding together within, you know, 90 days is very tough.
Well, we went on our honeymoon to Florida, and actually I probably only one girl who went on my honeymoon with two men. He went with he brought along his friend, who I figure out they're gays. They both gays, and we had one big room, and we was sleeping separately in different beds, all of us. So it was really funny and strange honeymoon. Even so, I had fun in the Sea World, and I really enjoyed this trip. Even so, it had nothing to do with honeymoon.
One of the first things that we talked about was having a family. Elena was very, very much wanted to have kids. We found out pretty early on that we couldn't have kids. That was extremely heartbreaking to her. And one of the things that I made sure that she was aware of, that, you know, whether or not we had our own biological kids or whether or not we adopted kids really didn't make a difference.
He wanted to have children, and I told him that I can't have children. He said, well, we always can adopt, so he wanted only one and I wanted two. Might even want another one, I don't know.
The original plan was to adopt one, and when I got the phone call that we were adopting two, it was a little strange, but you know, that's something that, you know, I figured, well, if we had twins, we would go through the same thing, so this way here we just adopt twins and go from there.
I love them more than anything, and took me 2 years to adopt them.
She might have had it planned in the back of her mind that, you know, I want to find two. And I know she had kind of said it jokingly a couple of times, but not until she made that physical phone call and said, hey, you know, we're adopting two children, did I really realize that, hey, we're adopting two children.
That they had this beautiful family. My wife, the Holy Spirit. gonna make a good singer.
I was about on 6 months, of being pregnant. He started to give me a really hard time. He started to tell me that I'm ugly, that I'm not worth things, that I will be very difficult for me to find job and everything. So he basically put in my head really some thoughts about really low self-esteem. I was hoping that after our child will be born, that we will get along much better.
I had to learn a lot when I came here. It was difficult to adjust myself to this culture, to this communication.
With Elena, it's night and day, where when she first came here, it was always, you know, we'll do everything that you want to do, and now it's more, you know, well, I want to do this, and it's like, okay, let's go. You know, so she knows more to be able to say her mind versus just letting me make the decisions and do what needs to get done. I want her to be what she wants to be. So it's not, you know, that she's here to be a housewife. She's here to be who she is.
He gives me choice whatever I want to do.
When I look at it, it wasn't just her experience of the novelty of being here and the newness, but it was also the experience that I was getting in seeing things in a different light. So going to the beach meant nothing to me, but taking her to the beach was the biggest deal in the world. It was, you know, oh my God, it's the ocean, and I'm just, you know, yes, it's the ocean, but I learned to see things differently. You know, she would point out something, say, "Oh, this is you know, magnificent," or this is really beautiful or gorgeous. You know, yeah, that is really, you know, something amazing to look at.
Recently, I had a dream. I was flying over the ocean. It was sunny and I was happy as a child. The trouble with flying is that sooner or later your feet must come back to the ground.
After I had my baby, he started really being nasty to me, and everything was just around the baby. He wasn't care about me or our relationship. As it was very difficult to live with him, I didn't feel like he's my husband, I felt like he's my roommate. Even so, he was trying to be my friend. That's the most he tried. Besides the Florida, we never traveled together. He went to the islands, to Bahamas, to the Bermudas. He never took me with him. I spent all year with a child when he was born, and in the evenings I tried to work in retail boutiques to make some money because Thomas wouldn't give me any money. So I've been working evenings, and Thomas was spending time with baby in evenings. We've been trying to be a couple for a year, and I felt like he was trying hard, and I hope it will work out.
First we came here, I had really troubles with understanding, especially understanding my Gary, because the way he talked, you know, I understood actually better other people than I understood him. What I didn't like in Gary, first, he never corrected my mistake. I hate it.
Other than the language difference, you know, and some of your friends, I mean, speak really good English. That's, you know, that's about it.
We didn't really had much in common, you know. First time we quarreled a lot, actually. it's not because we didn't like each other, but because we just were different too much, you know, different in cultures and different understanding the way we lived, the way we used to live. And I didn't like that he loves baseball and football. He spent so many time watching football and baseball and like all this stuff. It's awful. When he has free time, he wants to just relax, you know, and I want to go somewhere. And what I don't really like, didn't like, that he doesn't know much about his state, you know. He didn't show me a lot about place we live now, and I discovered it more with my friends than with him, so that's really not so good.
I think we get along well.
Yeah. If you can say so.
Well, he always had a guy friend, and he lived with his roommate for 10 years, and he's still living with him. The roommate of Thomas didn't like me. The first day I came, he asked me how long I'm planning to stay. And I said, well, hopefully all my life. And he said, well, we'll see how long you last. And that was our introduction to each other. Because I guess Donald was housewife of Thomas before me. I definitely tried to get rid of roommates because it was very small house and it was very inconvenient to live with a stranger guy. And every single day I was coming to my house and feeling that I live with two husbands that I do not love and do not want to live with. I don't know if they wanted three of us to be a family or whatever they were thinking, but it just didn't work out. It was really weird.
Remember we've been here before?
No, I don't remember.
Victor,
okay, take my hand.
Early on, we both were experiencing that whole novelty where, you know,
hey, where are you
we
going?
Really never got angry at each other. I don't think we really even got angry at each other within the first 6 months of marriage. But then you kind of get in that routine of marriage, and of course, you know, well, you know, I don't like what you're doing, I'm going to yell at you, and vice versa, you know. So, you know, the whole discussion point kind of goes away, and now it's all of a sudden, you know, you're yelling at each other a little bit, and you know, we do that, we still do that, you know, to our own degree, but that's part of marriage. But
that's great.
I think marriage is not as different as people would imagine it would be, you know, being married to an Eastern European woman versus marrying an American woman.
Okay.
Culturally, I'm learning as I go along.
You can't go there. Let's go.
So what's for dinner?
I don't really have a favorite Russian food. I'm very much not an experimenter when it comes to food.
10-15 minutes.
Really?
Probably our biggest differences is just in the sense of how we tend to deal with money issues. She thinks I spend too much. I think she spends too much. You know, it's just a, you know, there's a lack of communication there.
Mostly they speak in English.
Where are you going?
Because of Roger, and he doesn't like when I speak in Russian.
Well,
because probably he doesn't understand anything that I'm using some inappropriate words. They're born in Ukraine, and right now they are Americans. I'm hoping that we're gonna go someday to visit my parents, and it would be nice for them to speak
Russian.
Somebody's shooting!
It's gonna be scary.
What was that?
Look at
I think that the most important thing right now for both of us is the kids. I think we both see that, you know, there are some sacrifices that we both have to make sure that these kids grow up right, that they have everything that they need, and you know, really have a good life.
I got you that time.
I didn't like almost anything about my first marriage. Unfortunately, it didn't work out. And even so, I tried hard for things to work out. It was really difficult to change his thoughts. He has his own way of doing things, and he's very straight and clear about it. And that's fine, but his thoughts are really different from my point of view. So it was really different.
Thank you.
He wanted me to be his way.
That feels comfortable.
And his understanding of married life is really different of my understanding. Having married life, so this is where
like a princess.
The problems. He doesn't act like a husband at all. And he made my life miserable.
I do. I feel it's a really special day for me.
It's a different feeling from first time you got married?
It is definitely different. The first time, I felt like I have to do something. I felt like I'm doing the right thing, but I wasn't excited at all.
No.
But no, unfortunately, I'm not lying, but right now I'm excited and I think everything has to work out.
Do I feel homesick? Yes, I do. Sometimes when it comes to that beautiful nature and to relax, just like you know, to go camping and have a picnic. Yes, I miss that. I don't get this too much over here.
Like he says himself, he's not woman-orientated. He told me that he prefers men. I think it was arrangement for his side. He used me to have a child for him. He really didn't want a wife. He wanted a child. And he used me like a surrogate mother. It's what I feel. And it's what's in my heart after this marriage. And he always been telling me that he took me from Russia. And he did really great favor for me, and I should be thankful for the rest of my life to him. I wasn't thinking that this marriage would be for a reason of having a child for him, no.
Yeah, we actually still don't tell our friend that we are married.
Yeah.
Nobody,
I mean,
yeah.
No, only you know, some people know.
Yeah, only our relatives, your family, and not even all your family.
And no, that's not true. Everybody in my family knows, and some of my friends know.
I even don't wear any rings, you know, I never wear them because he gave me a ring, but I just don't wear, and he doesn't wear too, so we just like live together.
We like this arrangement.
It's funny, first I was like, yes, offended when first time I knew that he didn't tell his friends, his school friends from school. You remember Christmas, they didn't know. I was offended, yes, because I thought that he just ashamed of something. But after, I began to enjoy it, and I don't tell my friends it anymore.
And you still like to go to clubs and have boys talk to you?
Yeah.
She still has lots of admirers. Everywhere, around the world, right? We're just still young, enjoying, doing things together and...
Yeah, and not together too.
Yeah, that's right. You know, if there weren't all these government rules, we might not be married now. Yeah. We probably wouldn't be.
Yeah, everybody's first impression is that someone is looking for a free ride to get to America, and once they're here, they leave and you never see them again.
I believe that some Russian women, they trying to get married and trying to get away. Only the reason they're going away is just because they don't want to live in that environment. They go, they're searching for freedom, for money, for everything else. But and they're losing romance and they're losing love.
To be honest, I didn't think about any of what her motives would have been or any of the negatives on my part. More as I told people I was marrying someone, they would bring up all the negatives. Oh, she's only coming here to come to America. Oh, you know, I decided, you know, this is the person that, you know, I want to spend my life with. You know, whether it works or not, you know, that's my gamble. If it doesn't, I lose. If it does, I did something different, and you know, I you know, hopefully don't fall within the percentages of Americans who get divorced after X amount of years. So you know, if it lasts more than 10 years, you know, I beat the odds.
She will get what she needs out of it, and he will get rewarded for as long as it lasts.
We lived together for 2.5 years, and we have shared custody. And they're still living together, and they have wonderful relationships. I believe they created a family on their own, like they wanted. We share custody of a child, so basically half of the time Christopher is with them, and they're acting like both parents, because they have a family. You can feel it.
She went there.
I would never marry him, no. I wanted a husband, I wanted a partner of my life. I never wanted just someone to bring me here and make my life miserable. My life was miserable with him.
Mama, why are we going to go to the beach now? Why?
To say you the truth, as I told you, I would repeat, if I would be able to get the same money like people get here and don't pay taxes, I would better live in Moscow. My life here from economical part is much better, but I don't have here friends like I had there, you know, and friends means a lot to me. It's what I really don't like about American culture. People here, they have the families and they are very good in this, but they don't have friends. They have pals and they call them friends, you know. They have social friends with whom they can just hang out from time to time, but they don't really have friends.
You know, even if I thought that in the beginning, I know now better. When she comes home from work one day and says, I want to get out of here, I want to go home. You know,
I want to go home.
Basically, yeah, I do got what I wanted. I got my beautiful children and... well, I got some... my beautiful sister here, and so I made a lot of friends. I think I'm happy with my decision to come here. Yeah, I think I succeeded, and it's not all yet. I'll go forward and I'll do more and more. I'm never gonna stop.
Well, I guess I planned it for a long time, so I guess I'll try to do what I planned.
And now, with the power given me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I declare you husband and wife.
I'm getting married to a Russian guy, and I hope they'll work out much better than this American.
Did I tell you life is an adventure? A pretty scary one for some of us. So many choices, such a road we travel. A road that seems to close behind us as we move along. We can't return to the happiness we felt as children. Yet, we spent our lives searching for that feeling, as if it existed in a place. Maybe the truth is that we carry the roots of happiness within us. We are just looking for a place where it can grow.
Incredible to me that I have decided to link my life with a man from another country. I'd like every American man to have a woman from our city.
In America,
to work. A doctor.
Yes. Is that what you're studying, to be a doctor?
I want an American.
The man to be a doctor?
Yes.
Oh, I see.
In the future, I would like to have a loving man and a beautiful house.
I have both French and English.
You can do anything.
No,
I haven't decided.
States would be. I like American. I don't like British.
I think
our life will be very happy together. We will have a happy and die in one and the same day.
I'll say some words about myself. I think that I'm kind, sensitive, I'm rather intelligent, and I'm looking for a man